Welcome to Sarva Siksha Siddhipet channel. This is Sheikh Akbar from Telangana Model School, Kondapak. Today's our topic from intermediate first year mathematics 1A, that is functions. In that we will discuss about introduction and few definitions as well as types of functions. In that, briefly we can say that function is a specific relation, but we need to understand the different definitions related to functions. Let's see what we are going to learn today. Today we are going to understand definitions of ordered pair, Cartesian product, relation, function, domain, codomain, image, pre-image, and range. And we are going to understand the different types of functions also, in that one-one function, onto function, and bijective function. Let's start with the ordered pair. What is ordered pair? Let A and B are sets. If A belongs to A and B belongs to B, then A comma B is an ordered pair, in that A is called first component, B is called second component, right? In that, we have to remember one thing, that ordered pair of A comma B is not equal to ordered pair of B comma A. Both are different. Here first component or first coordinate in this A comma B is A, and in B comma A is B. So they are not equal to each other. If A1 comma B1 is equals to A2 comma B2, then we can say that A1 is equals to A2 and B1 is equals to B2. Next is Cartesian product. Let A and B are two sets, then ordered pair A comma B such that A belongs to A and B belongs to B is called the Cartesian product of A and B, and denoted by A cross B. Cartesian product means all the ordered pairs which may exist between A and B. Let's see with the example. I am taken one example here. A is equals to, set A is having the elements 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and set B have only two elements, X and Y, right? If we all the pairs, ordered pairs which exist between A and B is Cartesian product. Let's see how many ordered pair can exist between these two sets. Let here one is paired with X and one is paired with Y. In same way, we can pair 2 with X and 2 with Y, and 3 with X and 3 with Y. Here, all the ordered pairs, let's see what are they. A cross B is 1 comma X, 1 is paired with X, 1 comma Y. Next, 2 comma X, 2 comma Y, 3 comma X, 3 comma Y. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 elements, right? See, in that, they are all ordered pairs between A and B. Here, number of elements in A cross B can be calculated with the formula number of elements in A into number of elements in B. In our example, number of elements in A is 3 and number of elements in B is 2. So total number of elements in A cross B is 6. 2 into 3 is 6. And one more important thing is A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Cartesian product of A cross B is not equal to B cross A, but number of elements in A cross B is equals to number of elements in B cross A. Next is relation. A subset of Cartesian product is a relation. If A and B are non-empty sets, non-empty means they should have at least one element, then any subset of A cross B is called relation from A to B. Let's see with our previous example. I am taken A cross B as 1 comma x, 1 comma y, 2 comma x, 2 comma y, 3 comma x, 3 comma y. Here I have taken one more set which is having only two ordered pairs, 1 comma x, 2 comma x. It is subset of A cross B. It is subset of S is subset of A cross B. A cross B, so S is a relation. We can write 2 to the power of n subset. Here n is 6, total number of elements in A cross B is 6, so we can write 2 to the power of 6 subsets, that is 64 subset. It means we can write 64 relations between A to B. Next is important concept is function. Let A and B non-empty sets and F be a relation from A to B. If for each element A belongs to A, there exists a unique B belongs to B such that ordered pair of A comma B belongs to F, then F is called function or mapping from A to B. It is denoted by F is a function from A to B. Here one thing we have to remember, that for each element of A belongs to A, there exists a unique B belongs to B. Underline this term, each element of A. Let's see with the example, what is that? I am taking one set A as having the elements A with only two elements, that is 1 and 2, and in set B we are taking three elements A, B, C. As I have told you, for each element of A belongs to A, it means all the elements of A should be paired with elements in B. Here 1 is paired with A and 2 is paired with C. So our function F can be written in set form as 1 comma A and 2 comma C, right? Here all the elements of, for each elements of, all the elements are, you can say, for each elements of A paired with elements in B, but one element is left in the set B even though it is a function. Let us suppose if one more element exists in A, then it is not a function. By the definition of function, all the elements of A should be paired with the elements in B. So then it is not going to be a function. Then this is set A. Set A, we can say set A as domain. Domain of the function. And set B can be said co-domain codomain of the function, codomain of the function. And here A is called the image of A called the image of 1, image of element 1. Here 1 is paired with A, so we can call A as image of 1. We can write this one as F of 1 is equals to A. F of 1 is equals to A, and in set B, A and C both are images. Both are images. This set of images can be said, we can say set of images is a range, and this one is called pre-image. We can say this one is as one can be pre-image. It is pre-image, one is pre-image, A is image, and set of images is known as the range. Let's see the definition of range. If F is a function from A to B is a function, then F of A, the set of all F images of elements A is called range. In set form, we can define F of A as set F of A such that A belongs to B and it should be subset or equal to set B. Next is types of functions. We have three types of functions. In that, first type is one function, and it is also known as injection function. Right? A function F A to B is called injection if distinct elements of A have distinct F images in B. Once again, I am repeating, distinct elements of A should have distinct F images in B. One thing we have to remember, that types of functions means it should be a function, then should follow the property that distinct elements of A should have distinct F images in B. Let's see with the example, and we can say in other way, F is a function from A to B is an injection. It both side implies A1 A2 belongs to A, and A1 is not equal to A2 implies that F of A1 is not equal to F of A2. It means if two elements belongs to the domain and both are not equal, then their images should be not equal to each other, then only that is a injection. In other way, we can say that if two elements belongs to the domain A, and if the images of that elements F of 1 is equal to F of 2 implies that A1 is equal to A2, then images also, then elements also, if images are equal, then elements also equal. This is also a definition. We can say we use this to prove the injection function. Next, we'll see with this example. Look at this. In this example, I am taken set A having the elements A, B, C, and set B has the element 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, distinct images, distinct elements of A has the distinct F images in B. One is paired with only one, A is paired with 1, B is paired with 2, C is paired with 3. Every pre-image has different images. So it is called a function which is known as injection. In set form, we can write this function as A comma 1, B comma 2, and C comma 3. Right? This is all about the injection function. Next, we'll go to the surjection function. A function F A to B is called surjection if the range of f is equal to codomain of f, right? Once again, I'm telling you, range of f is equal to the codomain of f. Codomain of f. In other way, we can say that f is a function from a to b is an injection. Both side implies range of f is equals to f of a is equals to b, that is codomain. Or else we can say, for every b belongs to b, there exists at least a belongs to a, such that f of a is equals to b. These two statements also proves that it is a surjection function. Just we are defining in other words. Let's see with the example what is the surjection exactly. Here I am taking set A having the elements set A 1, 2, 3, 4 and set B have only three elements A, B, C. Here let's pair this. One is paired with A, two is paired with B, three is paired with A, and four is paired with C. Here the function f can be written as in set form, one is paired with A, 1, A, 2, B, 3, A, 4, C. Here, range of the function, range of f is equal to A, B, C. This is nothing but to the our codomain that is set B. So if it means in simple way, we can say that if the range is equal to codomain, then it is a surjection. But look at this. One is paired with A and three is also paired with A. It means it is not a injection, but it is a surjection. Different, it is 1 and 3 are not having the different images, distinct images in B. So it is not a injection function, but it is a surjection function. Let's see another type of the function, bijection. If a function A to B is both injection and surjection, then F is a bijection, or we can say it as 1-to-1 function, or we can say this is as from A onto B function. Let's see with the example. Here I am taking in set A XYZ, in set B ABC. By the definition of injection, distinct elements of A has distinct F images in B, and range of the function is equal to the codomain of the function. So it is satisfying the both properties of injection as well as surjection. So it is a bijection function. Thank you for watching the video.